Hi, I'm Daphne Richards, and this is Augie. Our plant this week is Texas betony, Stachyscoccinea. This striking plant is native to the Trans-Pecos region of West Texas, and it makes a great addition to Central Texas landscapes. Texas betony looks and feels especially at home in hill country gardens with rocky outcrops, where limestone boulders are commonly found half buried or even lying on top of the ground. Virtually no irrigation is needed once the plants are established, and there's definitely no need to fertilize. Texas betony is listed as hardy to zone 7 and is often evergreen in our normally mild Central Texas winters. If it does freeze back, simply treat it as a perennial, shearing it to the ground in early spring. You might notice the striking resemblance of Texas betony to its more commonly planted relatives, the salvia species. The flowers of Texas betony are a deeper, more scarlet red than salvia's, and the bloom stalks shoot further skyward, up to almost 3 feet. Our friends at the Native Plant Society of Texas list this plant as deer resistant once established, and that's due to the pungent scent of the leaves that gets stronger as the plant matures. Plant Texas betony in well-drained soil in full sun in a place where you can enjoy the show. Since it blooms from March through October, you'll be watching hummingbirds flock to the scarlet-red tubular flowers all summer long, and well into the fall as the zippy little birds start to migrate south for the winter. Shear back regularly in summer to encourage more of the striking blooms. Our question this week is, what does native mean? We often talk about Texas native plants, but as you well know, Texas is a big state with a wide variety of environments, so not all Texas natives do well in all areas of the state. Native to Bastrop most certainly does not mean native to Fredericksburg, and so when you decide to plant natives in your landscape, you should be careful to understand your own climatic and soil environment. Here in Central Texas, you'll commonly see regional information on recommended natives. In our partnership with the fabulous folks over at the City of Austin Watershed Protection Department, Extension here in Travis County assisted in developing the acclaimed Grow Green series of horticultural fact sheets, including the must-have Native and Adapted Landscape Plants Guide. Plants in this brochure are listed as native to the Edwards Plateau, the Blackland Prairie, or both. The Edwards Plateau has shallow limestone or caliche soil and is generally found west of Austin, while the Blackland Prairie has deeper, darker soils with a much higher clay content. Native plants that require well-drained soil and are extremely xeric would commonly be found in the Edwards Plateau region, while natives that can tolerate or might even need wet feet would be listed as Blackland Prairie plants. Our Texas betony this week is a prime example of a Texas native that's endemic to western, more arid regions of our state. So keep that in mind if choosing it for your landscape. Our viewer photo this week is from Matt Jackson, who caught this very happy bee on an early blooming Mexican buckeye. Thanks, Matt. To do in your garden this week, it's time to plant summer flowering bulbs like crinum, daylily, and canna. Oxblood lilies also do very well here. We'd love to hear from you, so please visit klru.org/ctg to send us your questions and photos from your garden.